Ahoy everybody, my name is Peter, and I'm an indie game developer working on a chill exploration game about taking it easy and making the most out of the last day of summer. I know I've been gone for a while, but I've been really busy with studying and working, and I might actually have a cool story to tell you all the next time we virtually meet. So, hoping you forgive me for the lack of applause lately, let's get right into the episode. In the last video, we left off with a simple explanation on how the game's area-based camera system works. I haven't really been recording or making huge progress since, but I did do start working on something new instead. You see, if I want to make my exploration and interaction-driven game stand out, one thing that is absolutely necessary is a solid dialogue system. So that is what I set out to do next. In the past, I have worked on a few iterations of a dialogue system based on a dialogue scripting language called Yarn. So the first thing I did was to turn to it and think about how to implement it in the game. This time though, I decided to take things a little more smartly and actually implement a Yarn spinner, a terrific support tool for such language developed by Secret Lab that offers a very handy Unity package to work with in the editor. By the way, if you find yourself enjoying this video, I would really appreciate if you consider leaving a like and subscribing to the channel, as that would really help me out a lot. Thank you so much if you do. To justify my choice of picking Yarn over any other dialogue scripting language or even writing my own, I will show you just how easy it is to create a dialogue with it. To create dialogue scripts, we can use any text editor, but the most convenient is the Yarn editor that supports syntax highlighting and most importantly, a visual representation of the nodes. In fact, dialogue scripts are composed by several nodes connected by edges that we can navigate through using options. And these same options will later be prompted to the player in-game to create a dynamic multiple choice situation. That's about it. Let's save the file and proceed to the Unity implementation. In Unity, Yarn Spinner's dialogue runner sends the text to the UI, which will only display the characters that have been read. Since I only want to dynamically resize the speech bubble when the text line begins, I needed to tweak Yarn Spinner's code a little bit, but I managed to get my desired result. If what you're thinking right now is, "Oh god, Peter, that UI work you've done looks like crap!" Well, you can really go and actually give yourself a pat on the back, because I totally agree with you. Thing is that before I can really pick the font and scale the speech bubble right, I need to come up with a design for the player and the NPC characters. I have already started designing the player, and I will try to bring the sketch to life in the time between this episode of the Devlog and the next. I will also probably be pinging you guys on Discord for feedback, so if you want to come give me your opinion on my poor 3D modeling skills or even show your own work, you are very welcome to join us over there. The link is in the description. Anyway, from the next one, things are getting kinda serious, so you better watch out for the updates. One last thing I wanna say is thank you so much, because I've been overwhelmed by the support under the recent videos, and I really appreciate you taking a minute of your day to enjoy my content. This said, I'm afraid our time is up for today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you made it to this point, I would love to read your opinion in the comments on what you just saw. As always, I've been Peter. You've been amazing, and if you decide to stick around, see you next time.